guys, welcome back to the JDHRacing YouTube channel. So today we're taking a pause from the Mopri and we're coming back to our first build and hoping to make a bit of progress on that today, so the Weasel. So what is the plan today? So the aim is to get the Hughes Performance transmission mounted up to the 4460, get that loosely in place, front clip re-bolted up, so we can then work out where all our new shock struts need to go. So as you can see, we've cut off the front end. So we need to get that re-established. So that's the plan for today. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe the videos. Drop a comment below if there's anything we can do better or anything you'd like to see. I'll do it for now.
He's a fucking dickhead, he's walking towards it, it's going to happen.
Fucking not.
So it does. The centre, I reckon it'd be perfect height by the time that's a dry sump. So I need to drain the oil. Lock the sump off.
Still need a couple of inches for dry sump.
I don't think, well, once it's sound there. We load it as is, onto there.
I think you'll find it end up having to go down.
Well, I might have to, but bear in mind that can sit straight onto the deck, not on the wood. The back needs to be supported, but the front will be sat on the wood.
You see what I mean? I think the trolley slides further under.
You what?
The trolley slides further under.
You can chop these an inch and put an inch and whatever off that by taking it off the wood onto
transmission going in the Weasel is a Hughes Performance transmission with an SFI case, big box floored bell housing, and it is the Promod. Promod transmission, so it should be rated 3000 horsepower. Was it 10 pack clutch?
Yep.
Should be good for all the horsepower that we want to throw at it. And then some.
Don't want to do this.
Sorry?
Don't want to do this. Setting them up in. All shiny.
Thank you. some slopes off. So it's deeper back, it's not slopes forward. So 35mm
will put you at the bottom of the chassis tube. So this engine will be flush. If we're setting this 3 inches off the deck, that means the trans sums won't ever hopefully hit the floor.
So a bit like Drew's broom, his came down, his sum is not lower than the rail, so it never hits.
Exactly. Otherwise you just shatter the track and transfer it, which nobody's going to forgive you for. So we just pull this back out, go up by 35mm on the engine. To me, it is going to be basically almost bang on three and seven,
which is perfect.
We'll put a bit more weight backwards to be honest with you. But then, unless we keep the turbos and the headlights, we're going to bend that off and then put them down here.
Honest.
I think we'll have an issue of weight in this car.
Anyway.
Yeah. Well, it's too much weight over the head. We don't have to put weight on the back end.
Turbos, I think, you go back.
But still works. You can't go back anymore. Without putting another 4 inches in the front. No, there's no other one. Because the transmission can't go back anymore because of the seat. That is our factor.
To be honest, it could have been a good idea if we could have bought the seat back in or put the seat back in. It's in the mode pretty much, isn't it? There's nothing else of equipment we've got, is there?
Got a Subaru seat.
Yeah. What's the width of that seat?
17.
Thank you.
2, so minimum of a quarter, so you've got minimum of an 8mm hole. Yeah, so just above, obviously, quarter inch. This quarter inch should be what? It's a mass now, maybe 4, 12, 16, 17, 21, 28. Talking about 6 odd mil, 6.5 mil, something like that. Quarter inch. We're at 8. 8 mil hole. Can you do me a favour, just bob across and see if I've got an 8 mil cobalt bit. I'm thinking if we do do a rosette top and bottom, because then it's going to get obviously butt welded. Do what? Just go get me an 8mm drill bit.
Five.
That one's centre, isn't it?
Yeah, because I'd rather stagger it so that it's rather towards the rear of the arch, purely because of the way the arch colour curves. If you go forward, you have to stagger forward.
No, that's fine, because so that one's centred.
Yeah.
This one then.
Yeah, because we go for about an inch stagger.
Which is your path?
I suppose it doesn't really matter, because it's one stagger forward, so either left or the right lane, you know, we get the same lane twice. So. What have you set the yoke to today?
What?
What's the yoke at? Do you need it to be half an inch in or inch in?
I'm there, yeah.
Half stagger.
Yeah, to the rear on this one. So I suggest moving this one forward slightly. To give you an inch.
We'll go for the extreme right inch and a half. See, I look at intake elbow, and I think, damn, that needs to be attached to a pro charger. There's no room for a pro charger because we've got a long gearbox. If we'd gone for a shorty, probably would have been an issue.
Hey, we say it, but that's like an £8,000 gearbox.
No, I know it is. I'm just saying, but had we gone for a short, had we gone for a shorty, where those bolts are is where.
Right, that's 1 inch.
Yeah, because had you gone for a shorty, you'd have finished here.
Oh well.
That's like, what, for me, 12, 16 inches?
Whatever. Anyway, so, that one's set centre, that one's set in, they're both at,
just confirm that one, because that one's 4, 5. Actually, this one's at
450. So, at least come out, smidgen. Oh, you measure it to the outside.
Yeah. Okay, there. Let's go back. Yeah, there we go. 4, 5. Is there?
Top cap there, on the collars.
Really?
Yeah, sort of chunks there taken out the top.
We'll take pictures and email Billy and just say.
You've unwrapped the other one properly now.
Yeah, unwrapped it actually, damage to that.
It's not cheap. That represents the best part I like to there.
Okay guys, thank you for watching the Weasel part 1, which is really more like part 20. Hopefully you've got an idea for what we're doing with the Mk1 Caddy build. It's definitely out there, it's definitely something different, and hopefully we can set an undisputed quarter mile record. Only time will tell. Please do follow the build on our social media. On Facebook is at JDHRacing and Instagram is at JDHRacing94. As always, if you enjoy the video, please do like and subscribe and drop a comment on anything we can do better. Thank you. Bye.